Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Hi, Bill. We're so glad that you're here. We're going to dive into advanced SEO today. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. My name is Nicole Lewillier-Fenton. We'll go through introductions and give a little bit more background on Bill Rowland, our SEO expert, in a few minutes. As you've been already doing, the chat box is where I will keep an eye on questions today. So please send us your questions throughout the presentation, and I will monitor them to the best of my ability. If there are particular questions that we don't get to today or something that you want to go a little deeper dive into, we'll put up our email address throughout the presentation so that we can follow up with you as well. So I want to just touch base real quick on some of the poll questions that have been up here. Bill asked us to ask some of these questions of you guys so that there's some sort of baseline and understanding of what types of folks in terms of technical experience and comfort level that you're seeing here. And so it looks like, Bill, I don't know if you want to share with us real quick, maybe why are we asking some of the questions? What does it help in the way that you frame the course?
Sure. Well, really what I'm trying to do, Nicole, is make sure that I have a good understanding of like what everybody uses, because obviously we wouldn't want, basic technical hurdles in our way as we try to like get through a lot of the content. So that doesn't mean that if you're on Apple or some other platform that it would be create a problem. We're just going to have to figure out the best way to kind of tackle it. So it's not the end of the world, but it certainly helps me to kind of for it, flesh everything out and make sure that it's presented in a way that's easily consumable.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Okay, so Kelly, let's take away some of those poll questions and let's get into the presentation here today. So we are going to talk about advanced SEO, and it's a really exciting topic. I've had the pleasure of taking Bill's course, and we're actually doing some deep dive SEO work with Bill right now. And so this is just such a fascinating and such a relevant course material for anybody who's really trying to understand how they can make a greater impact in their search operations. Opportunities to be found on the internet today. So, as I mentioned, my name is Nicole Lewillier-Fenton. I'm the Content Marketing Manager at the University of Vermont's Continuing and Distance Education. We're going to talk a little bit more about Bill and his experience. We're going to go through why SEO, of all the different things that you could deep dive into in digital marketing, why is SEO the thing that we highly recommend? What are some of those benefits to your business, to your company, or to your work as well? We'll go over the logistics of the course, the objectives, how it's structured, intended outcomes. And as I've mentioned throughout the presentation, please do ask questions in the chat box. And if there's something we need in particular, email us and we'll follow up with you. With you on that. I also do want to touch on, well, stick around, please, through the presentation because we have a really exciting kind of bonus module that is offered to our folks working in our digital marketing programs, which this is one, and it is career coaching. And it is an add-on at no charge to you, so that I would highly recommend you stick around so you can learn a little bit more about that opportunity. So I'm so happy to introduce Bill Rowland, who is our advanced SEO instructor and also teaches in our Fundamentals of Digital Marketing course, an SEO consultant, SEO director. You've been working in digital marketing for many, many years. E-commerce retailers of all different size. You help on content from an SEO perspective, really raising that visibility, the traffic, and hopefully revenue for your business. Experience in strategy, technical optimization, website development, content strategy, and that is a short list because I suspect there's many more things that you are very, very good at. So, Bill, thank you so much for joining us. Maybe let's just back up for 2 seconds. Let's touch on how did you get started in SEO? Why did, of all the things that you could do in digital marketing, why was SEO the area that you really wanted to focus it on?
Well, I think that I can probably I can speak for myself, and certainly from my standpoint, historically, I'd always been a little bit more technically inclined, and back in the day, I was fiddling around and figuring out how to create a website by myself, just using hand-coded HTML and things like that. And how I kind of found my way to SEO is kind of a circuitous route. Frankly, most SEOs that you'll ever speak with don't necessarily start out their career saying, "Hey, I want to be an SEO." So for me in specific, it kind of started when I was working with a family business, and I was responsible for actually building a, an e-commerce enabled website, quite a long time ago when it wasn't really, when there was still an awful lot of questions surrounding that. And I really found it very interesting. And I later actually went back to school and got my MBA. And as I emerged from that experience, I looked around and I looked at marketing, which essentially that's really what SEO is all about, in my opinion. And I looked at, well, where's the trend going? Where is there an opportunity? And so on. And I found that, at the time, once again, e-commerce was really just coming on. I was like, well, this is clearly a trend that's going to continue in the future. And so from my perspective, I was looking at the opportunity and I went in this direction. It really proved to be very fortunate for me. It's not only an awful lot of fun from my perspective, because a lot of it is about, essentially marketing and solving problems and things like that, but it's really grown quite a bit. So, SEO essentially is really helping searchers find a site, and also really crafting a site around what people are already looking for. So, it's really compelling and interesting. I've really, really enjoyed it, and I continue to enjoy it to this day. So.
And we appreciate the knowledge sharing that you do with our students as well, because your class, I can say from firsthand, is really fun, and the hands-on experience and knowledge that you walk out of this 4-week course is really fantastic. So let's talk about, you gave us a little bit of background as to how you've navigated the waters of digital and marketing to land as one of our SEO experts. Let's talk about why SEO. You've mentioned in terms of e-commerce and the need to be found more often and to be relevant to what people are looking for. We've got kind of a list here of why understanding SEO is so key and what that benefit can be for your organization. Do you want to just kind of walk us through some of these points today?
Absolutely. So really, from a grand standpoint, when you look at most businesses that are going to go online, the very first place that they will typically go will be to develop a website. And that could be everything from a very complicated and involved e-commerce website to one that just might be something as simple as a simple blog or an information site. Regardless, whatever flavor you're going to pursue, you want to try to do the best that you possibly can and make sure that your site is as visible as it possibly can be. And that's really where SEO kind of comes in. So from a, SEO is very foundational in nature. And a lot of it focuses around some technical components, but also some other components that are very common sense to the vast majority of people. So for example, you've probably been, most people are familiar with the idea of, keyword research and essentially crafting content or building a site around a particular topic. And a lot of that is what SEO is all about. It's trying to help search engines better understand what that site is about so that when Google crawls it, indexes this page and ranks those pages for queries, it's doing it as in a manner that's as informed as it possibly can be. So, overall, we're talking about boosting your online visibility from the get-go. So you're crafting a site, and a lot of what we're talking about here is building things out in a way so that Google can better understand it. It's also important to understand that as you're doing going through these basic steps, you're maximizing essentially the efficiency of your marketing effort. So there are many other channels that in time you may consider, but at least to start with, if you're building a website overall, progressing through, the steps in optimization will help you kind of get the most out of the time that you're spending or the money that you're spending. So that only makes common sense, or at least makes common sense to me. In other ways, SEO is pretty interesting, especially when you go through the research component, because it allows you to kind of, essentially do research on product development. And so there are many different ways to look at that. When you look at what are people searching for, what are the general themes, and what are the more popular products, or what are the more popular features, people will typically be looking for that, and that will help you understand, oh, well, perhaps I should be incorporating a particular feature or function in the product that I'm developing, as opposed to just kind of guessing, going to market with a product and finding that it doesn't really resonate with prospects. So that's pretty interesting. And then what's another component that I think you'll find compelling is that, you could be selling any number of products, or you could be building information around a number of specific themes, but a lot this is all based on competition. So I mean, generally, I've found that if you're putting methodical, consistent effort into your optimization effort, you're going to be well ahead of the vast majority of your competitors. Now, that's not to say that if you do a little bit of work on your website tomorrow, it'll just going to rank well. But what I am saying is that over time, you can still succeed, and that's really pretty important. There's some, smaller Companies or smaller concerns can succeed. It's still possible to do that, and it just takes concerted effort and an understanding of how to approach that. And a lot of that is what we kind of cover in this course. So going back, to kind of round things out, a lot of what we're doing here is going to be providing insight to, your products, your business, because as I said, it really is overall marketing. And then ultimately, how we distill down topics and how we communicate that as well. So that's really a lot of what we tackle in this course.
Question for you. And again, our folks listening today, if you have questions for Bill and specific about the course, please do put them into the chat box. I'm trying to keep an eye on those for us. I always find it interesting, Bill, too, in terms of SEO, it could be somebody who this is their own website. This is their own company. They might have a small e-commerce or medium-sized e-commerce or trying to build from small to medium. And they're jack of all trades. They're trying to accomplish everything. How would this course help to support somebody that might be in that circumstance? In addition, how would this course support somebody that has a knowledge of SEO and might be on a team and they might want to increase their knowledge? So how does the course kind of work the two different spectrums of the potential student joining us?
Right. Well, the way that I've kind of framed it out is really it's targeted towards specifically the former. So that person that's really starting out trying to build a base, and let's say that, starting from scratch, somebody wants to build their own site. And so it's really built around that. But I think that it's important to understand that, like, from my standpoint, every student has their own set of unique challenges. And so therefore, if somebody were to come to me and say, hey, I have an existing site, but I'm looking to build that out. I mean, that would be something where I'd typically give them some one-on-one help and guidance. And by the way, whether it be, in whatever situation you happen to be, I mean, and this goes with, everybody from our fundamentals course to, the last section with regards to advanced. And that is, like, you can ask me questions pretty much anytime, all the time going forward. So, I mean, that's not to say that I'm always going to be available to give you an immediate answer, but that just means, like, 6 months after the course, if you have a question or if you need some guidance or need some help, I'm going to be there for you, just because I think, to kind of your point, Nicole, a lot of it is information sharing. And it's a lot of what I do from a professional standpoint, whether that's be with clients, with, staff that I supervise or in some other, capacity. So.
Yes. And that's true. I'm can attest to that as well. I remember I was researching something for a particular project during the course, and I was seeing information and data in one of the tools, SEMrush or Moz, that you have us work in the course. And you provided some really interesting perspective on what I was seeing. So that's incredibly valuable. And so he really means it, guys. If there is questions that you have that might pertain to something specific that you're working on throughout the course, Bill is really great about responding. I have a question here from Nicolette. I work for a charter school and have been put in charge of handling the rollout of our new website, and we really want to focus on SEO, which is awesome. What should be my main focus when this isn't a typical website? So this is focused on programs and content, not necessarily e-commerce.
Right.
I think I'm understanding that right. And I think that, Bill, I was in the same situation, and I think other people in our course were too. There was another person, actually, I think, that was from a school. And so
yep.
How do you guide people through the course to be able to translate the knowledge into more service and program-based information versus retail?
Well, I mean, the same basics still apply. So a lot of the technical components, what we should all be looking for, are pretty much the same across the board. It's just somewhat of a different application. So, in that particular case, regardless of the type of site, my first advice to Nicolette would be like, all right, so if you're rolling out a new site and you're going from an old one to a new one, the biggest and most important thing is to make sure that we clearly communicate to Google that that's exactly what you're doing and where the old pages are, redirecting users from where the old pages used to live to the new pages, and making sure that's done in a very clean, clear, and concise manner, because generally speaking, that's typically where most migrations and most redesigns falter. And that is, people don't understand that essentially every website and every web page has value, or what I would call equity, and you want to make sure that passes over smoothly. So regardless of the type of site, that would be the first step to make sure that that's trying to prevent any kind of decrease when it comes time to migrate. So sorry if I went off on a tangent there, but I think that, whether it's e-commerce, whether it's lead generation, whether it's information distribution, or maybe a little bit of all of those, really the concepts are pretty much the same.
And from my experience too, in the class, having one of the things that I love about taking online courses is the fact that you're interacting and learning from each other as well. And so there were several of us who were more focused in the nonprofit and the service and the program piece and content for SEO. And there were other folks in the class that were more focused on the retail e-commerce side. So there was really interesting learning, I think, from each other. So hopefully both Nicolette and Kathy will be having that opportunity as well. So I'm going to move on just a bit, and I see Nina has a question there for us. I'll get back to you in just a second. So we've been talking a little bit about who this course is for, and so I think it's really broad. It's really for anybody who wants to understand how to have greater impact on your web pages. And so whether it's nonprofit and service and program focused versus e-commerce and retail focused, if really if there's a desire to have those pages perform better, then this course is right for you. I'm going to have you go through, you don't need to read all of these, Bill, but just kind of walk us through the structure and the things that you touch on throughout. You dive into the foundations of SEM, of SEO, and then and why it's important to do competitive research, and then maybe walk us through some of the actionable hands-on things that we get to do in the course too.
Sure. Well, I mean, first of all, we want to try to level set and make sure that everybody's, has a broad understanding of what those basic, SEO or search engine foundations happen to be, and then we kind of progress beyond that. We then start looking at, some high level, competitive research. And once again, we have 4 weeks to work with, so to speak. And so what I try to do is, rather than get too far into the minutiae, I want to make sure that everybody has a good understanding from a high level of what exactly is going on. And also provide access to resources that help you look a little bit more deeply if that's something that you'd like to do. We do get into some search engine ranking factors, and I think that I was actually giving some thought to this earlier. I mean, the challenge with search engine ranking factors is that algorithms are constantly moving. It's pretty indi recently it's been reported how, depending on the type of content that you're actually developing, it might be different criteria might actually be applied. So to some degree, to chase all the specifics of search engine ranking factors may not be super productive. I mean, Google more or less says that there's 200 plus that it uses. So that said, we typically will look at from an industry standpoint what has the biggest impact. Because we have to kind of prioritize what it is that we do. And so we kind of take a look at what are those big things that we really look at, what are the things that we can control, which includes things like keyword research. And we also get into a few items such as like, power search, how to identify, the number of, pages that are indexed, what are, asking Google to give us a list of all the pages, that are presented in the search results, things like that. We also talk a little bit about basic HTML. So, I mean, a lot of the stuff that we're going to be doing, we'll actually be working on on a site that I've prepared as a sample site. So people will be able to get into a WordPress site, optimize a title tag, add some copy, do things of that nature. So it's pretty rare that you get the opportunity to like really get your hands dirty. And so I think that's what makes it so important.
And in the slide I just put up is referencing some of the tools. And so you do get in there, and it is very hands-on. You are doing a competitive review, and everything that we learned in the course, I could then in turn apply to my own work that I'm doing here at UVM, or that I know people were going and in our cohort were taking back to their organizations and testing some of the theories and some of the tactics that we were learning in the course in real time. And so it's super beneficial. It's very actionable. It's very relevant. And I felt like everybody walked out of the course with a really strong set of tools in their SEO toolbox and their digital marketing toolbox. So I'm going to just and touch upon that for a second. Here's a few bits of information from some former students. And I really appreciated this quote from Tom because he really talks about the understanding of the fundamentals of SEO and how that is relevant and how it intersects with the other pieces of digital. And so oftentimes you see people that might be part of a team or know a little bit about SEO and really would like to be able to speak to it more knowledgeably to back to their team. And I always appreciated John's feedback here. He was really connecting the dots. And I think there's a lot of that that happens, whether you're taking the fundamentals of digital marketing course or you're deep diving into the SEO, you're able to connect the dots either for your own projects that you're working on related to your marketing efforts or as part of a greater team. And so let's just talk a little bit about the course structure. And so, and I'll pose this question to our folks that are here today. Has anyone taken an online course yet? And so feel free in our chat box to share with us if you've taken an online course. And we work in a platform called Blackboard. And there's a lot of interaction and there's a lot of feedback that you give each other in the course as well. So you're not only interacting and learning from Bill's instruction and the hands-on work that you're doing, you're learning from each other as well, which I think is really exciting. And I see several people say yes and several people say no. So it's really exciting to see that mix because it's a really great course if it is your first time taking an online course. And never use Blackboard. In addition, we also do have some tutorials for Blackboard. So if this is your first online course, and I'll ask maybe Kelly if you could just put up our email address in the chat box, please let us know. We have materials that you could watch in advance to get yourself comfortable with your first online course and with Blackboard. So we have plenty of resources to kind of prime you and get you ready for your first online course so that it you're really successful in that as well. We also have several articles on our website and our blog about how to be a successful online student. What does that mean? How do you compartmentalize your time? How do you fit it in? Because I suspect everybody on the webinar today is a busy person, and how do you fit this in? And in an intense amount of time, this is 4 weeks that you're going to be learning advanced SEO, and so how do you weave that in? And we're happy to share some of those best practices and tips as well. So how is the course structured? The course opens up on a Wednesday, and then as you're seeing here, and I'll have Bill kind of add some flavor in here too, you start with reading materials, Bill always does a really wonderful overview in the beginning of that module of Wednesday of like, what are you going to learn? What are you trying to accomplish this week? And then there are instructional videos, discussion boards, and new this time, which is really exciting, is the optional live sessions with you as well. What are you trying to accomplish with those live sessions, or what do you hope that, you know, people might bring to those live sessions with you, Bill?
Sure. Well, I mean, first and foremost, what I'm really trying to do is make sure that everybody's comfortable. And if they're feeling like, oh, I'm totally not picking up on this. The point being is that a lot of what we're talking about is very, very straightforward. And sometimes I think people might overthink, you know, some of what we're trying to do. It's really helpful to, you know, once again, reaffirm like, hey, this is how we do the assignment. We can walk through and do it together, or, you know, on the video if that's required. The point being is that I want to eliminate any kind of friction or any, you know, potential problems that each person might encounter and make sure that everybody's able to kind of like really get a good grasp of what we're talking about, how to distill it down, how to understand, you know, how they can use it on a daily basis, whether it be a side project, whether it be at work or something like that. That's the point, and making sure that there's some interaction there, because sometimes it can feel a little bit isolated when you're sitting there at your laptop at 12 o'clock at night, you know, trying to work on an assignment. But, you know, I'm trying to make it as easy as possible and make sure that everybody gets as much as they possibly can out of it.
That's great, and I can only attest to how valuable that is as well. The assignments are really doable. You know, I didn't feel like that it was overwhelming. They felt very tactical, but they felt relevant to any of the work that I was doing on the content side too. So back to our charter school and our nonprofit folks as well. The work that we did on the e-commerce side of in the platforms that Bill presented was still really relevant. A little bit more on the content side as well. And there are assignments throughout the course. It is a course. You will earn a certificate of upon completion of the course. And so it's rigorous. And so you want to put the time and the energy and allow for that. And there's work to be done throughout the course to demonstrate the learnings. And so it was really beneficial, I think, throughout the course to be able to show what you've been able to accomplish throughout this too. So, what will you receive throughout the course? Access to the reading and the training materials. Distilled U has a ton of great information, and there's access to that as part of the course. And Bill walks through different articles and hands-on learning that you do there. Diving into the actual website that Bill has built for this course, and you all have different assignments based on different keywords and different things in the website. Maybe walk us through that a little bit, Bill. What will folks be doing on the back end of the website that you built for this class?
Sure. Well, basically, what I'll do is I'm going to be assigning a specific set of pages to each person, ask them to actually perform keyword research around it, and then optimize each page. And that could include everything from title tags, meta descriptions, headings, the addition of copy, things of that nature. So that's really, once again, it tends to be a lot more than what I've seen in a lot of different, opportunities to learn. So I mean, it's a lot of fun, and people kind of can muck it up, but I mean, there's nothing that we can really break too badly. So it's a lot of fun. But the point being is I follow up and kind of check those pages to determine like, hey, did everybody have a grasp on what exactly we're trying to accomplish here? Or let's just say some people might have gone off on a tangent.
And so I think it's really helpful that there's those live sessions with you this time as well, because if there's something in particular that you're running into that you want a little bit more information, I think that's going to be super valuable. So I do see some other questions coming in, so I want to pause for just a second. And Anne Marie had asked for those tips, and it looks like that Kelly has shared those. And as I said, if this is your first online course, we do have videos and some other instructions to help you feel really comfortable with that. I just want to back up because Nina had a question, and she asked, have you been finding that the new WCAG standards are affecting SEO best practices? Any thoughts on that?
Well, honestly, I don't know what that acronym is for. So if Nina can elaborate on that, I'll be
Yeah,
happy
Nina,
to.
maybe share with us what the acronym's for, and so then we can dive a little bit more into that. And then I'm going to just zip down and see if there's some other questions here. We also hear from Toss, who says, do you recommend taking this course after completing the Digital Marketing Fundamentals program? I'm currently enrolled in that program, and that starts next week. I think, I'd love your perspective, Bill. I think either is fine. I think after is certainly appropriate because you're going to get the foundation and some information in SEO. You do a week of SEO in the fundamentals, is that correct?
Right.
And then
Yes,
this is
absolutely.
taking. Yeah, this is taking that knowledge and diving a lot deeper into that. Maybe what are your recommendations in terms of sequencing of that, Bill?
I don't think there's a big difference one way or the other. I think it's great that if you're in fundamentals, then you could then build on that with going a little bit more deeply. But I don't necessarily think that it's going to be a big step back if you took, let's say, this prior to that. And also, with regards to Nina's question, she's talking about accessibility. So, generally speaking, a lot of the accessibility components happen to be kind of baked into the development process. But you'll find that if you are considering, as you optimize a variety of different pages, generally speaking, good access, if you're optimizing overall, that's going to be typically consistent with accessibility. So, for example, title elements for images and things of that nature. So therefore, that is completely consistent with everything we do from an optimization standpoint. So I hope that I answered your question there, Nina, but if I didn't, hit me up and I'll try to elaborate.
Great, and thank you for that question, Nina. We really in that clarity on that question as well. We have another question. With this course, do we attend live sessions, or is it recorded, and we can complete the coursework on our own time during the week? And so, other than the potential live opportunities with Bill, it is not a live session course. And as I said, it opens on a Wednesday. Your first assignment is usually due on Sunday, and then the following assignment is usually due on Tuesday. So, yes, you can complete those as your schedule allows, just knowing and looking forward in your schedule to those two different kind of assignment points. Any other advice, Bill, as to how how you recommended students get the work done in their lives and their busy work schedules?
Well, I've found that the challenge is that obviously everybody's busy and they tend to leave everything kind of towards the back half of the week, so to speak. I do ask people to at least start to go through everything. They may not necessarily have to read all the material or start the assignments, but just to try to spend a little bit of time at the first part of the week. Maybe Thursday or Friday to understand, like, hey, where could there be questions? Now, that said, especially with the assignments, I do record a video to more or less say, hey, this is how to complete this assignment. So that would be a good place to start before you even get into it. So therefore, you can say, hey, Bill, I totally don't understand what you're talking about. Can you elaborate? At least that gives me enough time to get back to you and give you enough time to kind of digest the answer and make sure that you can apply it to your assignment.
I also, anybody who is interested in this too, you can shoot us an email. I created a graphic for a webinar that we did on how to be a successful online student, and it maps out a 2-week calendar and to when you can consider fitting your coursework in. It's not going to be super applicable to everybody, but it might help you to understand how you can fit this in into your busy world. And so I'm happy to share that as well. If you want to shoot us an email and ask for that, I'll share that too. Before I get over to Chris's question, and I want to be mindful of people's time, we're going to wrap up here in a few minutes. But I did want to share with you this opportunity for career coaching. As part of our digital marketing courses, there's this kind of extra bonus module that we offer at no charge. It has to be tied to one of our digital marketing courses, and the advanced SEO obviously fits into that. And it's a career coaching opportunity. So if you haven't freshened up your resume, if you are considering a career change or considering transitioning or advancing, this is an amazing opportunity for you to work one-on-one with a career coach, and she will help you fine-tune your assets in terms of what you're looking for to reach out with, where you're looking, how you're looking, what are you trying to accomplish, brush up on those interview skills, brush up on that cover letter. And so if you are considering some sort of career transition, advancement, anything, I would highly recommend that you consider adding this piece to your advanced SEO. And I know our folks that are in the fundamentals, this is an option for you as well at the end of fundamentals. So I really recommend it. And it looks like Anna Marie is looking for that graphic. So why don't you shoot us an email and then let me know. And certainly, my name is Nicole, and so you can certainly ask for the graphic that Nicole referenced in the webinar today. So here's the course logistics. So we just got to touch on the logistics stuff. Starts a little less than 2 months away, so March 18th. The course, we are do have a cap on the number of participants, and the course will fill. And so I highly recommend that if it's something you're interested in, put your name in there. Let's get you in so that you know and you're ready to go for when that course starts. I do want to head back over to Chris's question. Chris asks, will any of the assignments or projects cover performing and presenting site audits? I feel like this is a blind spot other online courses have, and it's probably critical for people who are looking to work in a corporate agency setting. So let's talk about audits, and that's something very relevant to some of the work we're doing with Bill right now. But do you touch on that in the course?
Well, the way that I present it kind of this way, Chris, is that we don't specifically lay out how to perform a lot, an audit, because a lot of the content that we're talking about here is, I guess, once again, a step prior to the audit in specific. Now, of course, from my perspective, I do audits all day, every day. So I can kind of talk to you in particular and even do a sidebar in terms of how to approach that. That's certainly not a problem. The challenge, though, is that so many people, that's starts getting pretty technical once you start talking about, time to first byte, canonicalization, rel prev, rel next, and a bunch of other elements. So a lot of the things that we cover here are should be included within an audit, but in terms of like the actual presenting, developing and presenting the audit itself, that's not something that we go into depth specifically for the course. But as I said, I mean, I'm pretty much an open book in terms of how I approach that. So, and a big part of our program is also access to sit down and work, work with me and, work with others to make sure that, you have the kind of information you need as you, go into that, whether that be a corporate position or something that might be a more modestly sized kind of opportunity.
Great. Thank you for that question, Chris, and thank you, Bill, for that response. So hopefully I've touched on everybody's questions today. I want to be mindful of time. We're going to wrap up here. If there's any last-minute questions, please let me know. As I've mentioned throughout, please shoot us an email if there's something that we haven't answered today or an additional follow-up question that you have. And Bill, thank you. We really are looking forward to this next session of Advanced SEO. And any parting words, anything that you want to share with folks as to why this course is the one to take in terms of advanced SEO work?
Well, as I said, I mean, a lot of what we're going to be doing here is like it's really going to be a lot of people's first opportunity to really kind of get your feet, wet or or what have you, and actually do some hands-on optimization and kind of go through it. And really, I mean, if you have your own site, if you have a specific site that you're working on through work or something else, I mean, we can sit down and we can actually tackle that together. I mean, and when I mean together, I mean you, me, and everybody else in the course to kind of identify, hey, how can we actually make this really impactful and helpful, not only from a learning standpoint, but something that can really, improve the performance of your business or your company's business. So, that's it for me.
Awesome. Great. Thank you so much. And Darren, I see you're saying it was a sales pitch, but I'm sorry that you thought that. We wanted to make sure that we covered the basics of the course, what you will learn, and hopefully encourage you to join us in this next cohort as well. So thank you, everybody, for joining us today. Thanks so much, Bill, and hopefully we'll see you when the course starts in March. Take care.
See everybody.